that those who would harm you will die screaming.
Fantasy drama Game of Thrones reigned for 8 seasons, following the tale of 9 noble families battling for control of Westeros, a mythical land. The show instantly became a fan favorite and was watched by almost everybody. It featured a stellar cast, including the likes of Emilia Clarke, Kit Harington, Maisie Williams, Peter Dinklage, and more. If you're wondering what the cast have been up to since the unfavorable final season aired in 2019, look no further, because that's what we're looking at today. Be warned, this may include spoilers, so if you've not finished Game of Thrones yet, catch up. Before we get into the video, make sure to subscribe to our channel and turn notifications on so you don't miss out on any more videos like this. First on our list of stars is Emilia Clarke. Game of Thrones was Clarke's first major television role with her portrayal of Daenerys Targaryen, and she quickly became the ultimate favorite amongst fans. Since the end of Game of Thrones, Clarke has starred in Last Christmas in 2020 with Henry Golding. She was also cast in the animation The Amazing Maurice, which will be released in 2022, and starred in the West End production of The Seagull, which was suspended due to the global health situation. She has been cast as the lead in the upcoming England production of The Beauty Inside, and will play the English poet Elizabeth Barrett in Let Me Count the Ways. Both have yet to begin production. Next up is Kit Harington, better known as Jon Snow. Harington won several accolades for his role as Jon Snow, and since then has signed up for several exciting things. In 2020, he performed a virtual extract from the play Burn by playwright Chris Thompson, and in September of 2020 appeared in the second season of Netflix's Criminal UK. In equally exciting news, Harington was announced to join the Marvel Universe in 2019 to play Dane Whitman in Eternals. The film is currently set to be released on November 5th, 2021. Sophie Turner is next on our list, and since leaving the show, has had a gorgeous baby girl. On Game of Thrones, Turner received a Primetime Emmy Award nomination for her portrayal of Sansa Stark, the honorable and strong half-sister of previously mentioned Snow. Since leaving the show, Turner had a baby girl with husband Joe Jonas in July 2020. Acting-wise, Turner returned to her role in the X-Men film Dark Phoenix, which was released in June 2019, and in September 2019 was cast in the thriller show Survive. She's not signed onto anything recently. We imagine she's just enjoying some time with her little one. Up next is Maisie Williams, aka Arya Stark. Williams joined the Game of Thrones cast when she was just 12 and was an immediate success. Arya Stark, the feisty youngest daughter of the Starks, thrust her into stardom. After Game of Thrones, Williams starred in the comedy drama Then Came You, 2019, the continuously delayed The New Mutants, 2020, psychological thriller The Owners, 2020, a 6-part revenge drama 2 Weeks to Live, and several other projects. On to Peter Dinklage and where he's at now. Tyrion Lannister, played by Peter Dinklage, reprised his role in the musical adaptation of Cyrano de Bergerac in 2019 to 2020, which he originally performed in 2018. This year, he also played mobster Roman Lenyov in I Care a Lot, a psychological crime thriller, and was praised for his performance. Lena Headey is next up with both acting and directing. Headey portrayed Queen Regent Cersei Lannister on the show, cast in the role after her friend and later co-star Dinklage recommended her for it. Since the show ended in 2019, Headey has kept herself extremely busy. She's since starred in 2019's Fighting with the Family and The Floor, and has done voice acting for several shows, including The Dark Crystal: Age of Resistance, Infinity Train, and Wizards: Tales of Arcadia. Headey also branched out of acting and towards directing, releasing her first short film, The Trap, in 2019, and has dabbled in directing some music videos. Now on to Jack Gleeson, who played Joffrey Baratheon, the character you just love to hate. While Gleeson only starred in 4 of the 8 seasons, we had to include him on this list because we absolutely loved to hate him. After leaving the show in 2014, Gleeson semi-retired from acting to instead take part in independent theater. However, recently, in March of 2020, Gleeson has returned to the big screen after being cast in Sam Pascoe's new miniseries, Out of Her Mind. Next up is Nikolaj Coster-Waldau, who played Jaime Lannister. Coster-Waldau starred as Jaime Lannister in all 8 seasons of the show, before ultimately dying by being crushed by the Red Keep with Cersei. Since then, he's starred in a crime thriller, Domino, in 2019 and 2022 thriller The Silencing. He also launched a production company called Three Kippers in 2019. Now onto Natalie Dormer, formerly known as Marjorie Tyrell. Dormer was critically acclaimed for her role as Marjorie Tyrell, but left the show in 2016 after her character was murdered by wildfire. In the years since, she has worked on projects including The Professor and the Madman, 2016, The Forest, 2016, Patient Zero, 2018, Picnic at Hanging Rock, 2018, Penny Dreadful, The City of Angels, 2020, and more. Gwendolyn Christie, Brienne of Tarth. Christie brought Brienne of Tarth onto our screens for almost all 8 seasons. A valiant but violent warrior. As well as working on Game of Thrones, Christie appeared in The Hunger Games trilogy and in Star Wars The Force Awakens. Since the show's ending in 2019, Christie appeared as Bounty Hunter in 2019's The Darkest Minds, and has signed on to Netflix's adaptation of The Sandman for 2021. Sean Bean, who played the Honorable Eddard Stark. Bean brought us Eddard Stark, the head of House Stark, for 8 seasons. He was ordered to death in the final season by King Joffrey. Known prominently for the Lord of the Rings trilogy, Bean has since appeared in a 2020 YouTube series, Reunited Apart, with fellow former cast members Orlando Bloom, Ian McKellen, and more. He also appeared in a 2019 TV drama, World on Fire, and will appear this year on a BBC prison drama, Time. Iwan Rheon, who delivered us the evil of Ramsay Bolton. Rheon starred as Ramsay Bolton, the psychopathic and dishonorable bastard son of Roose Bolton. He appeared in 4 of 8 seasons, leaving during season 6 after being fed to his own hounds. Brutal. Since then, Rheon has acted in ITV sitcom Vicious in 2016, was cast in 2017's Inhumans series, and appeared in the 2019 biographical comedy drama The Dirt. Outside of acting, Rheon is also a musician, husband, and father to his first child, which he welcomed in 2018. Charles Dance is still working with co-star Gwendolyn Christie. Dance portrayed Tywin Lannister in the first 5 seasons of the show, leaving in 2015 after being murdered by his own son. Dance has since narrated a 2018 documentary, Spitfire, appeared in 2019 Godzilla's King of the Monsters, and appeared in season 3 of The Crown that same year. Dance has also been cast in Netflix's adaptation of The Sandman, along with Gwendolyn Christie. John Bradley, who plays the epic sidekick, Samwell Tarly. Samwell is the epic sidekick of Jon Snow. Incredibly intelligent and highly awkward, he was a fan favorite and appeared in all 8 seasons and became the new Grand Maester. Bradley's portrayal of him was a fantastic performance, but since leaving the show, he's not done a great deal acting-wise. In 2018, he appeared alongside Game of Thrones co-star Natalie Dormer in Patient Zero, but not much else. Conleth Hill, aka the mysterious Varys. Hill acted as the mysterious and unpredictable Varys throughout the 8 seasons and delivered a superb performance. Since the show ended, he has appeared in 2019's Official Secrets and 2020's Herself and Here Are the Young Men. He also appeared in the crime drama show Dublin Murders in 2019, as well as psychological thriller Vienna Blood and medical comedy drama Doc Martin of the same year. Rory McCann, better known as Sandor the Hound Clegane. McCann played the incredibly brutal and violent The Hound throughout the duration of the show, killing countless people and loving it. Actor McCann has not since done any acting projects, but is by far leading the most enviable life out of the Game of Thrones cast. He lives a fairly solitary life and told Entertainment Weekly that he was just finishing up building his own boat when the show was tying up loose ends and planned to travel for a few years. That sounds pretty exciting to us. Carice Van Houten played Melisandre, or the Red Woman, on the show, appearing in the 2nd season. Van Houten starred as Melisandre, a Red Priestess, which is a deity not widely popular amongst Westeros. In the final season, after the Battle of Winterfell, she succumbed to old age after discarding her enchanted necklace. Van Houten was praised for her performance and has since moved on to more projects, such as a Dutch drama, Instinct, Helena Rain's directorial debut, as well as 2019's drama, The Affair, and thriller, Domino. Alfie Allen, aka Theon Greyjoy. Theon Greyjoy was the narcissistic son of King Balon Greyjoy, and ultimately died at the hands of the Night King. Allen originally auditioned to become Snow, but ended up playing Greyjoy as a regular for all 8 seasons. After the show ended, Allen appeared in the 2019 films Jojo Rabbit, How to Build a Girl, and The Predator. In the time since the show ended, he has also split with partner and mother of his child, Allie Teals, whom he was involved with between 2017 and 2019. Isaac Hempstead Wright, King Bran Stark. Like Williams back at the start of this list, Hempstead Wright was just 12 when he appeared on the show as Bran Stark, who ended up taking the throne of Westeros. Since leaving, Hempstead Wright has not appeared on any projects on screen but has been linked to a few. He's attached to sci-fi film Voyagers, which has been postponed repeatedly but is now set to be released this year. He is also linked to the heist film The Blue Mauritius, which was set to begin filming in 2018. As it is set to be filmed in South Africa, it has also been indefinitely postponed, but to date, Hempstead Wright is still tied to the film. That's all we have time for in this video, but let us know if you want to see another one like this. There are plenty more stars of the show to choose from. Remember to subscribe and turn notifications on so you don't miss out on any more videos like this, and we'll catch you next time.